My name is Valery Fedorenko. Today I show you like few exercises what you can do in a truck, what I do in a truck. Before each workout with kettlebells in a truck, you have to warming up yourself. You have to warming up your joints. I call this PTI for your body, same as you do PTI for the truck. It's really simple routines. You have to do 10-15 reps each routine. For example, you do wrist, you do this rotation, other elbow. It's really important. Make sure it's working, everything is working. You don't have any problem. You can do same time with two hands. Shoulders. It's really simple. With two hands. If you lift the kettlebells overhead position, of course you have to stretch yourself, stretch your shoulders overhead position. You can against the wall inside the truck and stretch your shoulder. Your spine. Ten, 15 reps. Your back muscle. Your feet. Your legs. Your neck. Couple inhale, exhale. That's it, we're ready to go. First exercise, it's a swings. It's really interesting exercise, really simple exercise, but I have to show you few points how you have to do. It's not complicated to learning, but at least you know what to do. You know what how it's work. Legs position, it's gonna be work for all this exercise what you gotta do. It's not too wide, not too near, just something in the middle, wide your shoulder. Next point, how grab the kettlebells. I do around like 45 degrees, not like this, not like this. It's around 45 degrees plus minus. Next point, how grab the bell. I know naturally everybody grab the kettlebell like this and put this finger over there, but you have to lock your finger. It's gonna be really good for grab the kettlebells and not really kill your grip fast. Lock your finger, this finger on top on this finger. Then you have to pull the kettlebells on a chest position right here. Elbow position, its elbow should be a little bit higher than kettlebells. Not like this. Not straight. Because in the truck you have not enough space. You can't do like that. It means you have to pull at the kettlebells and keep close to your body. It's really like a pendulum. It's non-stop moment. Another point, how you have to breathe. When kettlebell's going up, you inhaling. When kettlebell is going down, you exhaling. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Okay. I demonstrate like a 10 reps each hand. Make sure you have idea how it's work. And from the side, let's do this side. Recommendation: how many reps you have to do? Really, for myself, I'm switch the hand every 10 reps. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. For example, if you're beginners, you can work out really start with 40 reps and increase your number 60 reps, 80 reps, 100 reps. And I'm always say it's no heavy kettlebells. You can start, it's your choice, you can get light kettlebells and do up to the 200 reps. But you can work with really, it's about time. If you have 200 reps, sometimes it's get a little bit more time. But really around 30 reps per minute, 35 reps per minute, to get 100 reps, it's gonna get only 3 minutes, like 3.5 minutes. It's really fast and you get a lot of positive feedback. Your back working, your legs working, your heart rate going up. It's like a cardio machine. And how often you have to work out? Really, it depends after you. It's up to you. You can do twice a week. You can do every day. Depends how many reps you can do. For example, if for myself, I do 100 reps. One set, I can do every day. If I do 2 sets of 100 reps, I can do every other day. When I do this exercise, most popular time I do when I'm in a shaper or receiver. It's not get long time, you can do 1 set and feel really comfortable for your back, for your legs, for your shoulders, and for your full body condition. Another exercise what you can do, it's what I do, it's a clean. It's get the kettlebells and put in a rack position. Hold the kettlebells over there, right? It's like few points what you have to learning. If you cannot learning fast, it's up to you, but you have to a little bit study. And all these points, when you work with light kettlebells, it's not really gonna hurt you if you do some couple mistakes. When it's heavy, when it's sport, it's yes, it's important. But for our case, for your case, my case, light bell, it's really, you don't have to struggle of reload these points. But anyway, I have to show you how it's working, how it's gonna be looks professional, because professional drivers do everything professional. That's why I have to show you professional technique. Bottom position, you lock the finger and same time you get the kettlebells and put the chest position. Let's break it down. I do this, all these points for 1 second, but before you have to know how it's like a wrist position, your elbow position, your legs position. First point, grip position. That's what natural, that's what happened with beginners. You grab the bell and you hold it like this. It's empty space right here. But professional, I recommend do put inside. It's like a gloves. You put the kettlebells inside your wrist, inside the handle. This finger holding you. No empty space. You can bend your finger right here or right here. This is for safety. You're never gonna be, maybe someday you're gonna work with two kettlebells. That's the safety position, you bend your finger. If you hold like this, it's no reason to bend your finger like this. Another point, you put your elbow on the hip. What for? And rotate the bell like this. This is position, it's really for hold the weights. Because if you stay like that, not put the elbow on the hip, you gonna get more stress on your shoulders. That's what you put your elbow on the hip and extend your knees. If you stay like that, your legs gonna be tired fast. And do rotation between your shoulders and your wrist. It's really simple. But if you cannot reach your hip, it's about body type. Just get the kettlebells, make sure no empty space between your body and between your elbow. Not make sure it's not like this, right? You disconnect. Make sure your elbow connect with your body. Okay, I show you 10 reps each hand and you can see how it's work. About breathing, when you drop the bell, when kettlebells landed in the rack position, you exhaling. When you drop the bell in a bottom position, you inhale. Really, it's a matter of practice. If you not remember all these points right now, right away, it's about how many times you try. After like 5-10 sessions, you're gonna figure out really fast. When you drop the bell, you drop to the 45 degrees position, same as swings. That's why it's connect. Swings, clean, same position. How you have to do? 10 reps each hand, you switch. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 90, 100. For beginners, 100 reps, it's really, really good number. About speed, how fast you have to do. If you don't have to worry about speed, it's you. Sometimes you have no time to set up your clock or time. That's why don't worry about time. Switch every 10 reps. You can start 40 reps for beginning. And approximately it's about 10 reps per minute. Clean, it's gonna get, if you do 40 reps, it's gonna be 4 minutes. If you do 100 reps, it's gonna be around 10 minutes. It's really good exercise. And really fast. You can do only this exercise twice a week or 5 times a week. It depends what's number, how many reps you gotta do, and how many sets you have to do. But really simple concepts. 100 reps and you're done. Another exercise, it's a press. It's really simple how you have to do it because you already know how to hold the kettlebell in the rack position. Let's see how it's working press. It's nothing special. You put the kettlebells in the rack position and press. Okay. I'm demonstrate right away 10 reps each hand, and you can see. Switch. I like this exercise. It's not complicated, and it's your legs not involved. It's only pressing for your strength from your rack position. How we drop, it's like few points, how you breathing and how you drop the bell. That's your elbow. You know your elbow over there. Naturally, you're gonna start pressing from the shoulders. That's what normal reaction, but really our goal, straight the line like a drawing line, your elbow straight and drop, same, drop it to the right position. How breathing technique, really it's same as like when kettlebell's going up, it's inhale. When kettlebell's going down, you catch exhale. But it's not mean you do inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Sometimes you have to get rest on overhead position. Look at me. And when I'm drop it, I'm catch exhale. You always breathing. When kettlebell is going up, it's inhale. When kettlebell is going down, exhale. But you're breathing all the time. You never hold your breath because kettlebells, it's not heavy. You don't have to hold your breath to pressing. It's all about a lot of reps, not about max rep. How you have to do, it's again, 10 reps every handle you switch. It doesn't matter. You start from the right hand or left hand. I'm called this first hand, second hand. Somebody first hand, it's a left hand. Somebody first hand, it's a right hand. You can start to try how it's worth this exercise. Really start from the 40 reps. And again, don't be afraid. It's gonna be light kettlebells. I'm really recommend. It's you can start with 8 kilograms, 12 kilograms. Or 14 or 16 kilograms. Max, I'm not really recommend workout in a truck like 24 kilograms. It's no reason because you like to generate your energy, not like a lose energy. Another exercise, push press. What's the difference between press and push press? Everything works same, like a rack position. Push press, you have advantage to use your legs. I show you like 10 reps each hand and then break it down all details. Okay, what's the difference? What's like after you figure out how press and what's the push press? Push press, you use your legs, you pushing your elbow pushing kettlebells. You do like a half squat a little bit. How deep you have to do? It's kind of you have to thinking how you jump from the floor, right? Because sometimes people not really understand how deep you have to do first dip. Well, that's the position when you want to jump, right? To accelerate your power from your legs. Really, I like this exercise because legs always stronger than your arms. But once again, we working here, we try to lift light kettlebells, more reps, 100 reps, because it's not something heavy, it's about light bell and do a lot of reps. Start, move your blood working. And let's see again. First dip, right? And push it. When you drop it, you do half squat again, a little bit to make a soft drop. Not like straight. You have to bend your knees a little bit to make a soft drop. And catch it. Same principles, breathing, same as like all this other exercise. When kettlebell's going up, it's an inhale. When kettlebell's going down, you catch exhale. And drop it. Same principles. You have to switch every 10 reps, speed, how fast. It's around, and you don't have to pushing yourself working fast. If you need break, you can get a break and get rest in the right position. Doesn't matter, you can do 5 reps per minute or even 1 rep per minute. Get rest, thinking, focus it, what's going next, and make it right. Normal reaction when you're not really familiar with the technique points, you try to do fast, but this case you switch the hand every 10 reps. This multiply switch give you opportunity to do a lot of reps. But 100, it's a good number what you can start. You can start 40, but really when you hit the 100 reps, you can maybe get 12 kilograms or 16 kilograms. Another exercise, it's one arm jerk. It's really, I like this exercise because when you do this exercise, it's your legs working, your triceps working, your shoulders working, and your all breathing, endurance, everything involved. It's a little bit complicated, but I have to show you. And when you decide to practice, you can see how it's work. All right. What's the, after we talk about push press, you can see what's the difference. What's like, we added extra points. When you do push press, you do one dip and pushing the bell, right? Drop it, pushing the bell. This is a little bit more complicated. I see a lot of people have a problem getting this point, double dip. How it's working? I'm trying to explain, but it's again, it's a matter of practice. You do first dip, like a push press, first dip, and then in this position, you're pushing hard and catch it, it's going under kettlebells and drop it. First dip, accelerate and going under kettlebells. Really, same time, it's like complicated. That's what I do. Maybe if you don't like it, you can stay with press or push press. But someday, if you're interested, you can learning how to do this jerk. It's more legs involved. If you do push press, it's a little bit legs and your triceps working, your arms working. Kettlebell, one arm jerk, it's more working like a legs. It's basically 80%, 70-80% it's your legs. Your arms you use just to catch the bell. Really, it's your legs job. And again, same principles. You have to switch the hand every 10 reps. You know, I like multi-switch because it's no limit how far you have to go. It's from my experience, multi-switch hand compared to the one switch. It's like 7-10 times more you can do. For example, if you switch the hand one time, 50 reps each hand, it's only 100. When you start switch the hand multiply switch, it's possibly you can do even 1,000 reps if you're interested. It depends how heavy kettlebells. And technique it's same, rack position same, technique is same, breathing same like other exercise. Just this is double dip. If you don't like it, you don't have to do it. You can state only push press and press. Another exercise, it's a long cycle press, how it looks. Why I like this exercise? Because same time you do combine like two exercise, clean and press, but you do non-stop. You put the kettlebells in the rack position, press, dropping, do clean, rack position and going overhead position. Let's see how it looks. Okay, what's the difference between press and clean and long cycle press? It's nothing different. You just combine two exercises together, clean and press. But first you have to figure out how do clean correctly. And next you have to figure out how do press correctly. Then combine and do non-stop movement. Why I like this exercise? It's kind of same time, you cover your back, bottom, legs position, and same time you do press. It's your shoulder, your triceps, and it's about save the time. when you do this exercise, it's gonna be a little bit longer because you have to do clean, you have to do press. It's get a little bit slowly, you get this number of reps. But still, if you work in 10 reps per minute, but you don't have to worry about and count your reps, you have to switch every 10 reps. I like this exercise because when you do 100 reps, for example, when you reach the 100 reps, you're gonna be feel your back, you're gonna be feel your legs, triceps, shoulders, and your stamina, endurance, work capacity gonna be better. That's why this exercise, when you really have no time, you can do one arm long cycle press. Another exercise, long cycle push press. It's same as you have to combine two exercises, clean and push press. And that's why we call long cycle push press. And same time, it's I like this exercise because it's really you, for one exercise, you do, you hit a lot of muscle of your body, your back, legs, triceps, shoulders. But same time, you can do comparator to the long cycle press, long cycle push press. You can do a little bit faster, but you don't have to. If you don't like it fast, you can really rack position. It's that's where you can get to rest. That's it. That's one arm long cycle push press. And now another exercise. That's my favorite, best exercise. What most of the time I'm doing. But sometimes you tire from one exercise or other, right? You don't like to do something every day, every other day. You have to play with these numbers. You have to play with exercise. You have to play with number of reps you do. You have to play. Sometimes you combine, like you do couple exercise, like swings, clean together, or swings, a jerk. But this exercise, I'm most of the time I do this one exercise and nothing. I do 100 reps and feel really great. Just it's one arm jerk long cycle. Again, it's the same points. What's the bottom position? 45 degrees, lock your finger. When you get to rack position, all these points, what I'm demonstrating in rack position, you have to a little bit practice. And jerk. Use your legs, double dip, catch the bell, fixate, and drop it. And again, same time, you can do, start with 40 reps, 60 reps, 80 reps, or 100 reps. Or if you like to do, like maybe you do 120 reps, 140 reps, 200 reps. If it's light bell, you start with 8 kilograms, you start with, maybe somebody starts with 12 kilograms or 16 kilograms. It's up to you. It's make sure you're able to do around like 100 reps. But first, you have to start 40 reps. And how it's work? When you study all this exercise, you have to choose which one you like to study. Next, you have to do maybe 2-3 times a week each exercise. For example, you start swings and you do all week 40 reps. Second week you do 60 reps. Third week you do 80 reps. Fourth week you do 100 reps. It's basically for 1 month you hit 100 reps. And then you can switch the exercise. Or don't switch the exercise. Just do swings forever. Don't do other exercise if you don't like it, because just one exercise like a swings, it's already gonna be enough work for your legs, for your back, and for your stamina, for your endurance. Another exercise, it's a deadlift. It's really simple. It's not special technique points or something, but why I like this exercise, and sometimes I do it, and it's really like 100% for your back. After you do 100 reps, trust me, you're gonna be feel great. Your back stretching, and it's really a positive exercise for your back. It's really simple. Your legs position, it's the same. But questions, again, you can start with 40 reps or you can start with 20 reps. Depends how heavy your kettlebells, but I mentioned before, light bell. With two hands and up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. You can get to rest in this position or you can do faster non-stop. Oh, after 100 reps, I feel really good. I'm sweating like a lot of workouts. Just simple deadlift exercise. Another options, how to deadlift, it's I call this deadlift with half squat. That's why sometimes I do this exercise. It's better when you try to my legs work too. Not just the back muscle, legs and back muscle together. Just see how it looks. It's really, I love this exercise. I do half squat and use my back. Extend your knees. Squat, extend my knees. It's squat. It's like half and half. Deadlift and squat. And also you can speed up. You can regulate the speed. You can do faster or you can do slowly. Rest position, only this position where you can get to rest and do really slow. Never hold your breath. Same as like when you start with 40 reps. Or maybe 20 reps, because it's not multi-switch hand, it's just two hands. When you do 20, 30, 40 reps, you can increase your number every week. And when you try, you're gonna be understand what I'm talking about. Another exercise, it's a legs exercise. I call this half squat. I feel it's my opinion, it's no reason to do a full squat. It's no reason, because you worry about just these legs. It's about balance, it's about safety. It's no reason to do like a full squat. That's its half squat, how it looks. How it's look. We have to find a place where you have to put the kettlebells. Sometimes people hold the kettlebells, hold it like that, but I'm not. If you like it, I do like this. I put kettlebells on the back and legs position, it's same. It's like really for preparation for your legs for other exercise. You can do separately just the legs, one set a day, just one exercise. And again, just start with 40 reps or 20 reps, 30 reps, and you're gonna feel your legs even with light kettlebells. When you're gonna hit 100 reps, you're gonna be feel difference. Another exercise for legs, it's a jump squat. It's really a non-stop movement. It's similar like swings. Jump squat with kettlebells, it's similar. It's your non-stop movement. You just drop it, drop it, drop it, and catch the kettlebells. I show you how it's look. You put the kettlebells same position when you do half squat. And you don't have to leave the ground. When I show some people jump squat, then try to leave the ground. Don't do it. It's no reason. It's about catch the bell. Catch, drop it, and extend. Don't extend 100% your knees. Just drop it and catch it. This is really same feeling when you do swings. You have no place to rest. Same as like jump squat. It's a same feeling. It's no place to get rest, and your legs blowing up fast. It's really good for endurance, your legs. And same time, you can try, if you don't like, if you feel it's complicated, if you feel it's not safe, don't do it. But really, you can start 10, 20 reps, 30 reps, 40 reps, learning technique first. All right, guys, when you see all this exercise, what I'm demonstrating to you, it's about, you don't have to do all this exercise study one time. It's about I give you idea how it's work. First exercise, swings, clean, press, push, press. I demonstrate all this line, how like evolution, how you can get better and better. But if you choose only one exercise, for me, I sometimes do long cycle jerk, and that's it. 2-3 weeks non-stop, 3 times a week, 5 times a week. Sometimes I choose only swings and do like a 300 reps, 3 sets of 100. Or I do swings, I do clean, I do long cycle jerk, or do 3 exercises. It's a lot of combination, a lot of manipulation. But my goal, share with you, my goal, I dedicate this workouts for you exactly. And for myself, because I'm studying for this so many times, and I'm done like hundreds of workouts, and I figure out you don't need too much exercise. Really, you can choose one exercise, workout, make your technique better and make your conditioning better if you're interested. And maybe after you finish study one exercise, you can go another exercise. But one point, I'm demonstrate you all this exercise in my gym, not because I'm just demonstrate. Make sure you can learning something. You can make yourself better. You can increase your work capacity. And same time, I'm full-time truck driver right now. I'm gonna be work out with you. Next video you're gonna see, it's a live video. I'm gonna demonstrate how I'm use this exercise inside of truck, when I do receiving or shipping, you can see exactly how it's work.